Hey you guys, welcome to my channel, or welcome back if it is not your first time. Today I'm actually gonna be doing a video that has been so highly requested. Ever since I did one of my food science FAQ videos, a lot of you guys have been asking so many questions about what you guys can do to further your education when it comes to pursuing a food science degree, what you guys can do while you're in undergrad, what you guys can do post-grad. And if you guys don't know, I obtained my bachelor's of science in food science, and this is a topic that doesn't have a lot of information out there as far as people's experience and things like that. So I'm really excited that I can share my experience, I can share what I've been through, I can share what I've learned to hopefully help you guys that are aspiring to study food science and that would really love to pursue a career in this field. And so I figured I would go ahead and kind of categorize some videos based on topics, and you guys can definitely expect more videos on this topic because I love talking about food science. I just love the subject. So if you guys have any topics that you're really interested in hearing about, I have a little list going on here. I want to talk about like getting into a food science program today, but in future videos I want to talk about how to secure internships in your undergrad career, tips while studying food science in undergrad, teaching food science and how I became a teacher in food science, resume building and applying for jobs in food science, and a lot more. So if you guys would like to see that kind of content, definitely hit the subscribe button and give this video a thumbs up so I know that you guys like it. So today I want to talk about applying to be a food science student, what you need to do, where you can go, and things like that. So let's go ahead and get started. First things first, I have my laptop here just so that I have my notes in case, you know, there's certain things that I really want to mention. But when I applied for food science, I had no idea really what to do. I actually didn't even know how many schools offer a food science program. And I can definitely say that over the years, more schools have started to offer food science, which is awesome. I think food science is becoming a topic that is getting a lot more attention, which is great. And the first step that I had when applying to study food science, knowing your why. Why food science? Why do you want to go into this field? What do you hope to eventually do? Obviously, as time goes on, your goals and your why, it may shift a little bit, but you definitely do want to go into applying for this program with at least one why, because if you don't know why, you will get discouraged along the way. And so at the beginning, you want to know, why am I applying for food science? Why? Like, is it a booming industry? Do I like food? Do I like science? Do I think it's interesting? Do I think I could study this for 4 years, even when it gets hard, and still overcome and persevere? So that is my first and ultimate step. Like, know your why. Do not do it because, oh, the jobs pay well, or just because you think that you'll get to eat food on the job. Like, I think those reasons aren't, they're not sustainable. And so you want to know, why am I studying food science? Why do I find interest in the subject? And what do you want to do in the end goal, or what are some options? Because I promise you, it will keep you going and it will also keep you inspired when applying, okay? The second step that I have is to go ahead and apply to the schools, but you also want to know what schools offer the programs. So there are a lot of different schools, especially in the States, that offer food science as a degree program. But the coolest thing about food science, which is something that I wish I looked into more, was the international studies when it comes to food science. So you have the UK, you have the Netherlands, India, Germany, Kenya, South Africa, like so many different countries offer food science, and it gives you a good variety on the food industry. Like, food is something that is global, so it's really cool to see how a lot of you guys have been messaging me and commenting on my videos from different countries, asking all these questions. So in the States, we have to apply for programs by submitting test scores, your GPA, which is like your grade point average, and then we also have to do essays. So this is another thing. After you find all of the schools, look at, what are their requirements? What do they ask for? What are their entry statistics? Like, do you have to have a certain score on this test? Like, is that a reach school for you, look and see what schools would be in your bracket, like what schools are good schools for you to apply for based off of your credentials, okay? Because a lot of people think that you have to have really high scores to get into any food science program, and that's not true. You could have not that great of grades and go to a school that still offers food science. Their program may not be as rigorous and their program may not be as like prestigious, but you can still get into food science not having really high scores. The scores will help you determine what schools you will get into. So yes, that is something to definitely consider. If you guys don't know, I went to the University of Illinois down at Urbana-Champaign, and honestly, I love my experience there. They're not paying me, they should though, because a lot of you guys, I feel like I've definitely put them on the map a little bit with you guys, but Cornell is a school that offers food science, UC Davis is another one, Purdue, Michigan State, University of Missouri, Columbia, University of Idaho, University of Delaware, Iowa State, Ohio State, Penn State, and so many more. So you guys should definitely do your research and look up schools that offer a food science program, and then start making like a spreadsheet or something like, all right, this school, this is their GPA requirement, their test score requirement, and then their essay prompt or something. And I would highly recommend applying to at least 3 to 5 schools. Make sure you have a school that you know you'll get into because you meet their test requirements and things like that. Also do like a reach school. Do a school that maybe their requirements are a little bit above what you have, but you never know. You may be able to get in with that. And a lot of people often ask how many schools I applied to. I actually don't remember how many schools I applied to. I really wanted to go to U of I. I was like dead set on it. So I do regret not applying to more schools because my test scores were really good. And I wish I would have just at least applied to schools that were maybe a little bit more of a reach, because who knows what would have happened. So I recommend definitely apply to like at least one reach school, and then apply to some schools that like people consider them safety schools, because you know you're gonna get in, or you're confident that you'll get in. So yes, with that being said, a lot of high school students have messaged me asking just for advice about getting into a food science program. And I know I did mention like, oh yeah, well, even if your grades aren't that good, there will still be a program for you out there. That doesn't mean that you shouldn't try in high school. So if you're still in high school and you're still, you know, able to improve your GPA, I would highly recommend it, because depending on the school that you go to, that is highly recognized in the food industry. I can't even tell you how many times I've applied for jobs and all I've had to do is name drop, oh yeah, I went to U of I, oh yeah, I went to U of I, and they're just like, whoa, whoa, whoa. Universities do get recognized in the work world. Some fields, maybe not as much, but I will admit in food science, they do recognize what institution you went to. So I would highly recommend being aware of that. It's not a deal breaker though, it's definitely not. I wanna also say that some applications are really easy for college. People think that applying to college has to be difficult, but actually it's pretty simple. Writing essays should not be that difficult, because typically colleges just ask for like a 200 word prompt. Like 200 words is nothing. And I think for the U of I application back then, I think you had to answer 3 questions. One about why you want to be in the food science program. So that's why I say it's so important to know why, because they want people who are passionate in the subject. You have to have some sort of passion. You can't, like I said, it has no longevity if you're not passionate about your why. So, very important. When applying for university, I want you all to be aware of the difficulty and the course requirements. Every university should have a list of courses that you'll have to take to obtain a certain degree. So for whatever university you go to, they should have it on their website. U of I has it on their website. I'll try to put it on the screen here. And it shows you all the courses that you have to take. So I would recommend when you apply to a school, look and see what is their course requirements look like. What kind of classes would I get to take? Look at that. A lot of people make this mistake and think that food science is all fun and games. People think that food science is all about doing experiments and eating and taste testing and sensory tests and fun, fun, fun. Like, food science is fun, but it's a lot of work. It is difficult, and you will be thinking. You will be doing a lot of work that doesn't always involve food. So I hate to break it to you guys, but there are classes that you take that you never see food. You never even talk about food. Like, these are other classes that you have to take in order to understand other concepts. Like, for example, chemistry classes. Those general chemistry classes are just general. That is the prereq to food chemistry. So keep that in mind. A lot of the courses are difficult, especially when you get to the higher level. That is why it's so important to maintain your why and always check in on why am I doing this? Why am I studying food science? And what is my goal? Do I want to be a product developer? Do I want to be a food analyst? Do I want to be a food engineer? Like, what is your goal? Because you have to always keep that in mind to keep you going. Do your research, because everything is online. You can learn about everything you need to know prior to applying. So definitely check that out before applying, because it'll give you a good idea on what you're getting yourself into. So the next step is extracurricular. Think about what else beyond having good grades and good test scores are you involved in. I know some schools don't really care as much, but U of I did care about what you do in your free time. What have you done aside from go to school and just be a student? And so at the time I was actually a competitive athlete, and then I also helped out with my culinary teacher. So that really showed them how interested I was in food, how willing I was to volunteer my time, and then also how active I was and how I was able to maintain a good GPA, good test scores on top of also being an athlete. I did cheerleading, I did cross country, and I did track. Honestly, it was so much fun. So any high school student watching this, I highly recommend that you get involved. Do something aside from just going to school. Do anything that you could add on top of your application, because there are kids that are out here killing the game, and universities look at that when admitting people. And I personally have talked with admission counselors at U of I for their agricultural program, and I remember she was just telling me, like, it's so important that students are involved in the school. Do something aside from just being a student. At the end of the day, grades are not everything, but being a whole well-rounded candidate is important. And I know some students who are international students, that is important too, because as an international student, you want to stand out as well. You're competing against domestic students that may have different opportunities that you all don't, but then internationally, you guys have opportunities that we don't have here. And so internationally, I would make sure that you do something or mention something that really sets you apart from other candidates, because a lot of people have good grades and you want to be something more than just good grades. So try to find a balance. Well-rounded candidates really do stand out. That is pretty much all I'm going to cover for today's video. I figured in these videos I can also answer some questions at the end of the video from old videos, comments on the videos, Instagram messages, all of that kind of stuff. So if you guys would like to get your question answered in a video, I would leave all the questions in the comment section, and in future videos I will answer some of them at the end of the video. So this is a question that I always get. How do you score a job? And this is a video that I'm gonna do all about landing your first job in the food industry, how to go about that, and internships. Someone said, please guide me, how can I get a job related to food science? Recently, I completed my degree of master's, and they sent their resume to my email. So a lot of you guys keep sending your resumes to me. At the moment, I actually have nothing to do with hiring. So even the job that I work at, I do take part in some of their hiring, but yeah, I'm not hiring. Sorry about that. The next question is, hi, I love the video. Thank you so much. I'm quite interested in taking food science, but when you took up the course, was math hard? I saw it had engineering and chemistry. Thank you for your answer in advance. Very good question. I had to take calculus. That was the only class that I had to take regarding math, and it was hard. I thought I liked math, but calculus I did not like. And I think what made calculus so hard was that I waited until my senior year to take it. So my recommendation for any undergrad student or anyone pursuing a food science degree, try to take math as soon as you can just to knock it out. But I waited till the last minute. don't be like me. Don't be like me, because I had all kinds of senioritis and I did not care. So don't do that, but it was a struggle. But if you're good at math, then maybe it won't be as difficult. So for me, I'm more of a science person. I'm more of like a problem solving type person. And when it came to math, I was like, nah, not for me. But I ended up doing okay in that class, and obviously I ended up still getting a degree. So you really just do what you can. Luckily, my grades in other classes were really good, so the math class, it wasn't a big deal. I would even say the engineering and chemistry classes were easier than math. People may beg to differ, but like I said, the way that my brain thinks, I like problem solving, different like equations and things like that. Math does have equations, but it was just a little bit different. Someone said, is it possible to do food science even if math isn't your strongest subject? I think this career sounds super interesting. Yeah, absolutely, like I said, if you have other strong skills, I would recommend still doing it. And with the right resources, you can still do well in a subject like math, even if it isn't your strongest one. So definitely don't let that discourage you or deter you from doing it, because anything is possible if you put in the work. So, yes. Someone said, do I need to know how to cook to become a food scientist / technologist? Crying face. No, you don't. This is the common misconception that a lot of people have, is that food science is being a chef. It is not being a chef. Food science and culinary arts are two different things. They have similarities, they both involve food, but food science regards the chemical, physical makeup of food and the science behind how those things are made, how those things are developed, and things like that. Culinary is cooking, and you're more so studying the cooking methods. You do not need to know how to cook. Not all food scientists will cook in their labs, and a lot of food scientists and technologists' jobs are more experiments. And so depending on what kind of food you end up dealing with, that will determine if you end up cooking a little bit at work or if you end up doing something else. Even in the program at your university, they will teach you all you need to do. I remember I took a class where it was kind of like a cooking class, and they taught us all the different types of cooking methods, and it was so much fun. So don't think that you need to know how to cook in order to start the program, because they'll teach you the things that you need to know. Those are all the questions I'm gonna do today. I have so many questions that I'm really excited to answer and get to. So if you guys like this video, definitely give me a huge thumbs up and leave me comments down below letting me know what you guys would like to know more about, what you guys need tips on, and how I can give you guys content that really helps you on your journey. So if you guys are new to my channel, definitely make sure to subscribe so you do not miss out on my future videos. And follow me on Instagram, because Instagram is so much fun. I love posting, and if you guys ever wanna see what I do in my daily life, Instagram is where it's at. So I hope you guys really enjoyed this video, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye, you guys.